Hello everyone, this is the video about how to solve a non-linear time series problem with a dynamic neural network using neural network time series tool app. Using this tool, we can able to solve three kinds of non-linear time series problem using a dynamic network. Also, this tool allows you to solve three kinds of non-linear problems like NOX, NOR and NEO. And this app also provides to generate MATLAB scripts to reproduce the results or customize the training process. How to get the NTS tool? Here in MATLAB command window, just you type this tool, NTS tool, you will get this type of window. Today we are going to discuss about how to predict the pollution load for next 6 months with the help of this neural network time series prediction and modeling tool using MATLAB. Here there are three kinds of problem selection is here. This is representing NOX, that is nothing but a non-linear autoregressive with external exogenous input NOR XX. Then non-linear autoregressive is called as, shortly is called as NAR, that is NAR. There is NA, what is NAO? That is a non-linear input and output. It predicts Y of T given D possible values of series XT. Here on a NAR model, that is non-linear autoregressive model, predicts series Y of T given D possible values of V of T. Similarly, predicts mean NOX problem, predicts series Y of T given D possible values of YT and another series of X of T. Here we are going to discuss about predict the pollution load for next 6 months. Previously, I am using this one. The 5S data calculation, the 5S data for pollution load. These are also our inputs. This is our target. Here, how to solve this problem, this kind of problem, that is a non-linear exogenous problem. These are also considered as our input. 5S data is our target. Based on that, you can use this app to predict the model, solve the non-linear. How to get this one? This is the introduction to time series tool. Here, if you another way in MATLAB command window, just you type N and start. Here, there are MATLAB neural network toolbox having the four interactive app. First one is called fitting app, out input and output curve fitting toolbox. Then pattern recognition and classification. This is in MATLAB command window. Just you type NPR tool. If you want to clustering, this is a clustering app. How to get the clustering app? By typing NC tool, you will get. Then that dynamic time series app. Now we are going to see about this type of tab, that is a time series app, NTS tool. In command window, just you type NTS tool, you will get this type of window. Here some small introduction. Prediction is a kind of dynamic filtering in past in which past values of one or more time series are used to predict future values. Here I already discussed the three options are available. Here in step by step we are going to see this already inbuilt example. This one simple NOX database. Here once you select a NOX input, that is this one, you say select the NOX input, you will get this type of window. Here you have to select the data, what inputs and what inputs and targets define your non-linear autoregressive problem. Here you have to select the input by using by the type of matrix type. This is a target, we have to take the target steps. Otherwise, here some small examples are there. Load example data sets means you will get some more inbuilt examples are there. Based on that, you can set the red W. You can divide up the steps for inputs are 70% for training and 15% for validation and testing. The next one on the network architecture, if you select a model, that is a three type of models, based on that you can create, you can structure neural network. The standard NOX network is two layer fit for one network with a transfer function, is called a sigmoid transfer function. Also this is a hidden layer and linear transfer function in the output layer. The default number of hidden neuron is set to 10 and default number of delay is 2. If you are giving larger data set, try to improve your performance. You can increase the delays, number of delays. That is a number of delays. The default value is 2. If you change 3 or 4, your neural network performs better. Similarly, next step is train the network. Select the algorithm. Here there are 3 options are available here. The default algorithm is Liebenberg market is recommended for most of the problem, but gives some noisy. Then another option is, if you click this drop down list, there are 3 options are available. 3 training algorithm is available. The next one is Bayesian regularization. It can take more time to train, but give the better solution. Then third one is a scaled conjugation gradient training algorithm. It is recommended as it uses gradient calculations, type of gradient calculations used. Then after you selecting this training algorithm, click retrain, click train. Then you are getting this type of window. Then your training successfully done, you will get this type of window, type of output plots window. Here there are depending upon your selecting NOX model or NIR model or NIO model, you will get different types of plots output options. Here you are selecting NOX output so that you can get performance plot and training state plot and histogram plot and regression time series response and error autocorrelation and input error cross correlation options are available here. You have to train until the validation is stopped. This mark is important. The training is continued until this validation is error fail to decrease for 6 iteration. There is a default one is 6 iteration. That's when you training is started, the progress is shown in this type. The minimum step is, minimum number of iteration is 6. Based on your data set, it may be increased. Then this is the output correlation graph. This is the correlation graph. If you get autocorrelation here, if you type autocorrelation in error autocorrelation, means you will get this type of window. And this figure shows how the prediction errors are related in time. The next one, for a perfect prediction model, there should be only one non-zero values of autocorrelation function, and this should occur at a zero flag. This is called your zero flag, zero lag. This is the mean square error. Here it is shown correlations and zero correlation, and this is your confidence level. The next output is the input cross correlation plot. Here is the first one is a error autocorrelation. The next, if you click here, you will get input error cross correlation like this. Here this is the output. This figure illustrates how the errors are correlated with the input sequence. Then the solid end is called as, this were correlations and zero correlations, and this a dotted line shows. This dotted line shows the confidence level. For perfect prediction model, all of the correlation should be zero. This is your aim and objective for getting better performance. Then time series response plot to validate the network performance. To validate your created network performance, the time series response plot to validate the network performance. This figure displays input and output that is targets and errors versus time. Here it shows the training targets and training outputs, validation targets and validation output, the test targets and test outputs. Also this orange color shows the errors. Here the next one is a response. It also indicates which time points were selected for training and testing and validation here in this manner. Here time series plot, how to get the time series plot. Here you select this one, time series plot, third one. The next one, how to evaluate the network using this interactive neural network time series tool. At this point, you can test the network against new data. If you are not satisfied with your network performance, you can do one of the following. First, train it again, retrain it again. This is the first option. Then the next one, increase the, you can adjust the network size. Already we discussed, increase the number of hidden neurons, and also increase the number of delays in this option here. Here, so you can increase the number of hidden neurons. Also, you can increase the number of delays if you have not satisfied your result, or you are given large set of inputs, can use this option. Then next one, get a larger training data set means, again you can optionally you can perform the additional test. Here itself you can set the additional inputs and targets. Here time step you have to give, for example cell column is your input values in column formats means time step column format, you select column, otherwise you can set matrix column. And here also three options are available. Here if your data is in rows format or data column format, here you have to select. Then finally you have to deploy your solution. You can generate deployable version of your training network. Use this panel to generate a MATLAB function or Simulink diagram for simulating your neural network. Also you can use this app. You can use the generated code or diagram to better understand how the neural network computes outputs from the inputs, or either deploy the network with the MATLAB compiler tools. Here MATLAB compiler tools are available, and also your MATLAB generation tools are there. Here there are four options are available. Here you can generate MATLAB function, you can prepare neural networks for deployment with the MATLAB code tools. Here by using MATLAB matrix only function, this is a MATLAB function script file. Here mains only, this is your main function. Here simulate your or generate your MATLAB function with matrix only arguments. There is no cell array is supported in this format. Then you can generate Simulink model of your neural network, or deploy with Simulink code tools. Then the final one is graphics. Generate a graphical diagram of your network, shape of network you will get. Then you can save your result. After you are applying inputs and targets, you have to get the prediction data. How to where you get the prediction data? Here you can select. This is generate MATLAB scripts of your train data. You can click this simple script option or advanced script option to create a MATLAB code that can be used to reproduce all of the previous steps from the command line. Also here you can create the MATLAB code. It is helpful for you want to learn how to use the command line functionality of the toolbox to customize the training process. Here you have to check in checkbox, you have to click here save network to MATLAB network object format. Here you can select all the format. Also you can select this one, save inputs to the MATLAB matrix name. Here now we are getting this type of tool for predict the position of the load. In this command prompt I have given the command NTS tool. After that I will get this type of tool. Here there are three options are available. Here I am selecting first nonlinear autoregressive with external exogenous input, that is an ARCS model. Click next. Here you have to select the inputs, how to select the inputs and how to give the target values. Here you can see this is our data, pollution data, 5S pollution data. These are the temperature, TO, pH, conductivity, nitrate, and these are the targets, total coliform and BOD values. Here I am choosing this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 inputs. I am choosing this one. How to give the inputs here in workspace. Here also there are in MATLAB window, this is a general format. It shows the main window, it shows the current folder window, it's a detailed window. This is your workspace, this is your editor window, this is your command window. Here in workspace window, just you select new. I'm choosing here inputs, and also I want to set the targets. Now in inputs, double click on that, you will get in the editor window, you will get one plus one mat file. Here I am choosing the 5S data. As inputs. Here after that I am choosing in this format the rows and column format. Just I transport it for my matter convenient where if you transport this 6x60 variables are there. The next one I am choosing the target. This is my target, it's a BOD value. Here also I am choosing the same thing we have to give. For example, 6 class 60 means the target also 6 class 60, 60 matrix value, so that I am transport the values here. Now you can see 6 class 60 and 1 class 60, this should be same. Now you go to this prediction window, this is where target. Now we are, I am selecting this inputs here at the input panel, the drop down list, we select input, then targets. This is available only if you create this workspace, or you can import your workspace as input and output targets. Here I am creating the input and output targets, so with the name inputs and outputs, so that I am available here in this neural network tool. Here inputs and targets is available in the same label, so that I am checking inputs and outputs value, and I am setting target value. Here I am setting here in the column row, column value. I am selecting this column value, so that I am selecting the column format, matrix column format. Otherwise, one more option is here. If you want to check this neural network time series app with example inbuilt examples, means here you can select simple NOX problem, click import, you can see the outputs, what are the outputs here. Here there are different types of examples available here. This is a simple NOX problem. It has the data set value, that is a simple NOX data set, like your pollution data set. That heat exchanger example, this heat exchanger example having the name exchanger data set. This here also you can see here inputs 1 cross 4000, the output target is 1 cross 4000 cell arrays. But like that we are using 6 cross 60 and 6 cross 60 input and target values. Here this is another example called the magnetic deviation examples. Here also it has 1 cross 4001 cell array and 1 cross 4000 cell array input and output targets. This is the pH neutralization process example. This is a pollution mortality example problems. Here there are 8 different inputs are used: temperature, relative humidity, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, and nitrogen dioxide and hydrocarbons and ozone. Finally, some particulars are there. These are all inputs. Here outputs are total mortality and respiratory mortality and cardiovascular mortality. Here I am choosing this BOD values. Based on that, you can select this. The next example is a fluid flow in pipe. If you select this one, click import, and the steps are discussed with in my presentation section. So based on that, you will get the output value. Here I am choosing this. Predict the pollution load for next 6 months with the help of this interactive time tool. Once you select the get the data from workspace. Workspace is nothing but here, this is one workspace. After getting the data from workspace, you select the time series format to NN data. Here it may be cell column, or it may be matrix column, or it may be matrix rows. I am selecting here because I am choosing this matrix column format inputs, so that I am choosing this matrix column. Click next. Here this is the option we already discussed. This I leave it in the default value. There is a number of weighted neurons 10, number of delays here t. This is a problem definition. These are our neural network, created neural network with x of t 6, that is where 6 class 1 inputs and the hidden layer is 10 and the output layer having 1 and the final output where target is 1 row, that is our one row column. Next, click next. Here creating the network. After training, the network may be converted your feedback layer into closed loop for this one. Then this window shows how to train the network to fit your input and targets. Here there are 3 more algorithms are available here: Liebenberg algorithm and Bayesian regularization algorithm, scaled conjugation criterion algorithm. You can see if you select this one, there is some description available here. You can see, for example, I am selecting Liebenberg, means this is algorithm typically requires more memory but less time. This training automatically stops when generalization stops improving as indicated by an. Here some description is available. Here if you select base n means these algorithms takes more time but gives a better result. Then scaled conjugation, conjugate gradient. These algorithms request less memory. Training automatically stops and the generalization stops improving. Here the default one, Ravenberg, I am choosing this one. This option is a training option. Here after training will your input data set is taken for training, validation and testing, testing performance. After that you are getting this this mean square error and regression values according to your inputs only. Now I am train this network. Click in this option, click train. Your training network is started. Here at 8 iterations where validation stops. This is our network. This is our algorithm data division algorithm. This is our random data division algorithm is used for training. This is a training purpose. Levenberg Margaret algorithm is used for training and performance is we check base performance, mean square error performance, that is MSE performance, and calculus in mixed format. Here this is a progress, what are the may push, what is the time step, this is what is the performance gradient and validation checks. This is our output plots, how to check the performance. You click performance. You will get the best validation performance is 35.2294 at every purge point. Your blue lines indicates training data set and the green line shows validation data. This is your test data set. This data line shows your best one. Here our neural network MTS tool, that is MTS tool, predicts this model that best validation performance is at 35.2294 at your approach. Here there are totally 8 approach, that is your 8 iteration as used for training. Here this is your best performance validation performance. Here then you can create the training state. Say it shows the gradient gradient MU validation checks at for 8th approach. Next one, error histogram. This is our error histogram. This zero error line should be available in between 0 and minus 1. 0 and minus 1 value. These are exactly 0. 0 values. It shows the real, value, error histogram value with 20 bins. This blue box shows as a training, and this one green box shows as our validation data set. These were test data set. These were zero error. Here error is calculated, where calculated is the difference between your targets matrix versus your output matrix. Then next one is a regression model. Regression. Here you will get the performance training for training and validation and testing and all over. Well, if you are not satisfied with result means you can retrain again, then we will get a better result. Just you check with all the plots, time series plot. Here these are all the response output element, one for time series up between your output and target versus time and error versus time. These are all the training states. The data line indicates training states. The plus symbol stores as the training outputs, and the green dot stores as our validation targets, and the green plus target stores as validation outputs, and this one and this is a test output. Well, this orange line shows are errors, and remaining is the response. Then input autocorrelation function. Here where autocorrelation of error all should be zero. Here this point is in above the value autocorrelation values. This is used to validate the network performance. It describes how to prediction errors are related in time. For a perfect prediction model, already discussed, there should be only one zero. Like this is a correct one. Only one non-zero value of autocorrelation function, and it should be occur at zero lag only. This is a mean square error. If you are not satisfied with your output means, you can retrain it again, or you can choose any other algorithms according to your Levenberg or Bayesian or like a scaled conjugation method. Then next one, the input error cross correlation. Here, this is a correlation between your input one and output. So you are getting the better result, correlation result. So all are available in should be zero for, but you are for already discussed, for a better perfect prediction model, all of the correlation should be zero. The input error cross correlation function shows how the errors are correlated with the input sequence x of t. Okay, now you can see analyze their plots function. Then next one, here also you can select at the tab the plot window, training window. Here also you can see your results. Here it shows the mean square error and this regression value in your statistical value. Next option is next. Click next. Here you are not satisfied your result. Here itself you can see the mean square error. This is the average square difference between your input and output targets. Here lower values are better. Zero means no error here. This one. Then the regression value, R values measure the correlation between output and targets, and R value of 1 means a close relationship, 0 means a random relationship here. Next step is your optionally you test your network or more data with so for example if you have to import large data set, you can use this option. If you import large data sets, or you can adjust the network size, you can increase the hidden neuron, you can increase the delay. Here train again means train the your training process is repeated. Here then one more option perform optional test here. These are you can select here number of inputs and number of targets with the new data set. If I am satisfying with this result means you click next. Here you can see here only inputs and targets only available in workspace. Now I am deploy the solution or generate the deployable version of our trained neural network. Here you can say by using this option you can generate a MATLAB function with matrix and cell array argument product. This is option and second option to generate MATLAB function with matrix only arguments, no cell array support in this one. Can another option is you can simulate or generate a simulate diagram, simulate a neural network in simulate or deploy with Simulink coder tools. Here there are different types of coder tools are available here. If you want to get the generate the Simulink diagram, you click this option. The next one, you can generate a graphical diagram of neural network. If you click here, you will get the graphical diagram of our NOX model, that is a prediction of pollution for the next 6 month model. These were inputs, these were output. Here hidden neuron selected as 10 and the transfer function, that is output transfer function is 1. Here I am choosing this MATLAB function file. What will happen? Here based on your values, it shows the neural network function, neural network simulation function generated by neural network toolbox with this type. There are all our input and outputs programs. Here also here what type of transfer function you use means sigma transfer function, what is your minimum and maximum output reverse processing function. These are all automatically generated MATLAB codes. Then click next option. If you want to create with function only function means if you use this one. So only function only. Here you can see the generated MATLAB script. You can analyze the what is the difference between this MATLAB function with function and without function. This one can generate the MATLAB script with matrix cell array using this option means matrix and cell array argument support. Here only argument support, we are not MATLAB function with matrix only argument support. Then this is a Simulink diagram. You can click this option, you will get the Simulink diagram. It takes some more times to generate Simulink diagram. Please wait. Here generating option is there. here similarly you can choose any type of but you can predict any future values. For example, you can also analyze the forecasting for foreign exchange rate and foreign exchange rates, money rates, using this Knox neural network app. This is our symbolic diagram of your created design, neural network model. You can see here itself you can change the parameters, pre-process inputs and pre-process initial input and outputs value. Here itself you can change. Here you can view the result using this scope. This were generating MATLAB symlink. Based on that you can choose. This is the automation process. Here itself you can change your inputs and input. This is like your input layer. This is your main network layer. This is your output. After that you can see the outputs in the scope, or here itself we based on that you are listening, you can generate C, C++ code, HDL code, PLC code. These are all so many options available in MATLAB Simulink. Here next option, if you want to get the result, click next option. Here you can save the result. Here once you generate a Simulink diagram or generate MATLAB script, you will get the output result with the simple script and advanced script. You click simple script. This is your X data and what is your program, simple script format. Next you can select advanced script formats. You will get this type of MATLAB program. Here what is the difference is, you can generate, if you click simple script means to train and test neural networks as you are what you did this with this tool. If you want to get the advanced script means generate a script with additional options and examples codes. Additional, what is the additional option? Here you can see, just you can analyze what is the difference between your simple and advanced script generated by our MATLAB tool. Then save to data workspace, or here some more options are available. Here you save outputs with MATLAB matrix format, or error format, error and performance and data set information. Here these are all the output save in this workspace. Here I am choosing only output saves output. So here you click the save results option, you will get this one. What are the types you are clicking here, you will get this type of what is your error, what is your input. Previously in workspace only input and targets only available. Here a lot of options are available. Here this is your outputs. Then click finish. Here now you can see what is my output predicted by time series. These are all the output predicted by time series tool. Just if you are checking with your previous data, these are 3.4, 3.1 and all things we are predicting value. Just you check this one, we are 2.5, 1.7, 4.2. These are all our predicted pollution load output for next 6 month values. If you are not satisfied with this result, you can choose you can select any other algorithm. You can say you can increase the number of hidden neurons or increase the number of delays. Based on that you can get this type of output. Here next one, I want to see the error value. Here you can see the error value and what is the information stores, what is the training and what are the data sets taken for your training data set and validation data set and test data set. Here what is the performance and regression. It gives the values, performance values 12 point, regression value 0.4. based on that you can select. We click net option, what is your neural network dimension and connection it shows. This is a target value, then tout value. Based on that, by using this interactive app, you can solve nonlinear auto regression neural network with exogenous inputs. Thank you for watching. This is already my previous video shows the Knox neural networks example with inbuilt MATLAB function file. Here we are using external value how to create. In this video shows how to give the input, how to create input and targets from workspace. You can import your data to the MATLAB model by using the NTS tool. How to get the MATLAB script file, generate a MATLAB script file, and how to get the symlink diagram, and how to see the result. In this video we are discuss. In next video we are going to discuss about forecasting foreign exchange rate using this Knox neural networks, and also in next examples you can able to see the failure prediction analysis. Don't miss this video. If you like this video, subscribe my channel, and also share this link to your friends also. Thank you very much.